How do we do it together?
Hi.
This is...
Do it again.
We say, what's up, yeah?
Yeah.
Wagwan.
Rubbish. Rubbish.
Rubbish. Okay, do it. What's up, people? I'm Jocelyn.
I'm Tameka.
And I'm Ninia.
And we're here to tell you
that Free Non-Blonde
is coming
to Netflix.
Yeah!
Surprise!
You can watch season one and season two of Phenom Blondes.
Yeah!
Netflix.
I'm so happy. I'm just so chuffed, innit?
I don't think we realised that it was going to be the cult show that it was.
I think at the time, we didn't think we were making history, but I remember at the time thinking, wow, we're three black women on the BBC doing our own show. And we've got the freedom as well. We've got the freedom to do the stuff that we want to do.
To me, it was groundbreaking because we were doing foolishness, and foolishness just wasn't associated with people that look like us. We were allowed to just be free women being silly. Oh yeah, they're black. But first and foremost, they were just silly.
Do you realize I'm naked under this coat?
And I remember feeling this buzz that we're going out there to make people laugh. We're going out there to have jokes. We're getting paid to just have fun.
Mm-hmm. You what? Mm-hmm. Take the thing off your face. Mm-hmm.
It was a time when we were our authors. We created the narrative.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It was us. It came from us. Did you like that?
You know what, Jocelyn, it's about you.
it's just the narrative of the dichotomy, the juxtaposition, darling, dispelling such myths.
It's not like a studio show, so we're going out in the public. We're interrupting people doing their daily things. It's amazing what people will do when they don't know a camera's there.
Is there a sex shop around here?
No more blacks! No more blacks!
We dressed up as tampons, dropped our skirts and rubbed our scrotch on the ground. Do you remember, Jocelyn, when you used to do that?
Could you imagine us inside of your missus?
We'd get recognised a lot, but there was one time when I was on my way to a gig doing stand-up and it was pouring with rain and I went to get a taxi. And as I gave him the address, he looked at me and he went, nah, I know who you are, and drove off because he thought I was like filming some stunt show in the rain.
I remember when we first did it, I used to get a lot of people coming up to me and saying, no pictures. But that was my Marcia Brown character, you know.
Hello, sorry, I'm Marcia Brown, as in the Marcia Brown.
The diva that never was, but was in only in her head.
Hi, babes, Marcia Brown. Your daddy's rich and your mama's good looking. So hush, you little baby. Don't cry.
I mean, I'm still getting recognised now, yeah?
Yeah, but Nin, that's because you keep walking around dressed as a tampon.
Get it? No. Do you know what? I still got that costume. Yes. And here it is. Oh, no.
I can't believe you still recognise me. I don't know why. I mean, I just dressed as a tampon.
I know a lot of the times I just wanted to take my clothes off. I don't know why. So I would go, why don't I just drop my skirt? Oh, why don't I get undressed on a tube?
Is that near where the train station is? The big train station, yeah.
I think we all the reason why it worked as well is because we all naturally had that part of our brain that enjoys that sort of comedy, that sort of, you know, we'd, especially if we were doing a sketch, if there were like two of us or all three of us together, I mean, yeah. They were the hardest ones.
I have to say the one that sticks in my head and how we got through it.
Let's say it together, African royalty.
Yes!
African royalty.
That's it.
I have the Queen of Swaziland in the drawing room of the Radisson, and she's here for a really short visit, and she just really would like to meet some British people, and she's seeing you from the window.
Let me tell you, that that sketch, it will always make me belly laugh.
Just just everything. Jocelyn speaking English and an African accent. Me speaking one African dialect, then another dialect.
So just juggle and it's and I'll sing. Every time I see you, I see you.
It was, yeah, definitely our favourite. I think that's another one where it's because it was all three of us. When all three of us were working together, it was just because it was also harder to keep a straight face because it's three of us. Remember, we used to have people like, they'd always say, oh, before we go out, because that's how they spoke, before we go out, we put on three non-blondes while we're getting ready. When we get back, right, and we've had a few drinks, we put on three non-blondes. So literally, it was like, it was, but then also you'd have people like family sitting and watching it as well. So it what was the question? Sorry.
You answered it, Jocelyn.
Why was it good? Because it was funny. Not being boastful, but the question was asked. Why was it good? Why did it have a second series? Because it was funny.
What she said.
It was a really lovely journey. A lovely journey. And it's only when you look back, you realise how special it was.
Yeah.
My sisters. And we're not blonde. And you know what? Because of Free Non-Blondes, I will never be blonde.
Defo. Defo. Defo.
Wait! I have another look.
Jocelyn.
You know, I was going to wear this, right? Because I was like, the hair's not done, innit? So, it's my shower cap. Yeah. 1, 2, 1, 2. Hope you enjoy watching Free Non-Blondes on Netflix.
Yeah.
It's number 6 in the sticks. We are Bix.
Get on.
Bix. That's right. Thank you very much. Thank you to everyone who has continued to support us and watch Free Non-Blondes over these years.
And now, finally, you can watch it on Netflix.
I hope you enjoyed our comeback. And if you didn't, that's your problem, innit?
Yes, it's mine.
Love you all. Love you all.
Love you all.
Bye.